Blender is awesome. With each update, it's getting easier and easier to create a short film.
I mean, yeah, it's still hard and many people sadly quit, but the reason for that isn't lack of talent, but of planning.
So as a person who has 2+ years of experience in Blender and is working on its own short film, I want to show you how to actually make your dream movie. Firstly,
when most people think of creating a film, they see this big target. I mean, damn, it's massive. You know what else is massive?
So when people imagine this big goal and don't know how to even approach this, no wonder they get scared and unmotivated. And that's where I come in, to solve all of your problems.
Not really, but at least I can break down this big ball into a pipeline that can make making movies fun and rewarding.
Probably the most important step is coming up with an idea and plan.
No, wait, please. I know you heard it practically everywhere, but please. Hear me out.
Because most people fail because they don't do this. When I say planning, I don't mean woo, write the story, blah blah blah. I mean do that, it's also kinda important, but what I mainly mean by that is you should realistically assume your skill level. If you are good at, for example, creating environments, make that your main selling point. Of course, you should experiment, but put your skills as your strengths. If it comes to the idea, think not only of the plot, but also world building. There are lots of good tutorials on it. But I recommend the Patreon video of Ian Hubert. He's the guy who is making Dynamo Dream, and his video is tailored for people making films in Blender. So just consider that. Alright, time to finally create your masterpiece, but whoa, slow down, partner. Hold your horses, because you need concept art first. Not only that, but you need an animatic, which is laying out your film with rough storyboards. Luckily enough, Blender is the best software if it comes to creating it. You can use grease pencil to draw 2D images of your characters and put them in a 3D space, or you can be a talentless piece of shit like me and actually create your animatic with 3D characters, giving them some poses or creating very rough animations. Remember, it's not supposed to be pretty. Don't try to create a Mona Lisa. The only job of an animatic is to show you how many shots you will have to create, what will the composition look like, and the movie's runtime.
By the way, if you're planning on having voice actors in your film, this is the part when they will record their voice lines.
And finally, we can move on to the modeling part. You're most likely a one-man army, so let's be real, you're not gonna create every single asset in the movie.
Depending on your budget, you'll either commission it or buy it from some website.
And it's okay not to create everything. I'm saying that because I know there are some people like me who would like to make every single model, but after trying that approach, I failed miserably with the character look. Like, look at that. So after learning that, I commissioned a new 3D model of the head. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm still making a lot of assets because I love it, but it's okay to use other people's models. If it comes to actual modeling and texturing, there are a lot of great tutorials only on that topic, so definitely watch them. With that, we finished the pre-production phase, and if you liked the video or learned something useful so far, you can subscribe to my channel and like the video because creating this shit takes fucking forever. But we can move on to the actual full production phase.
Okay, you have a finished script, you have everything blocked out, you have all the models, now what? Death. Also known as animation.
This is the part that will take you the longest, no matter which approach you will choose. Speaking of approaches, you have two main options.
Option A. Motion capture,
which guarantees you faster and more realistic results, especially with human faces, but costs an arm and a leg. Like, holy fuck, Rococo, please sponsor me.
There is also option B, keyframe animation,
which is better for non-realistic characters, but holy fuck, it will be a very long process. Also, animating is something that requires an actual skill and effort, and is really hard. My advice is to learn the 12 principles of animation and find some course on animating, because the topic is really complicated and proper guidance can save you a lot of time. Personally, I bought the course Alive and I am really happy with it, but do your research and find what suits you best. Just remember to be patient about it, because it's gonna be frustrating. But now we can move on to something simple, which is lighting. Compared to the animating process, lighting is like, I don't know, it's just easy. probably the most important thing is to keep your subjects separated from the background. You can achieve that with 3-point lighting method, but I think you heard that a million times.
What I think is equally as important is that the lights need to have a justification.
Here's what I mean by that. I wanted to give the character a red glow from the right, so I turned on the car lights and added a soft red fill. It looks much more realistic now. That's the kind of approach you need to have when planning your lighting. The placing doesn't need to make sense, but the final product just needs to feel right.
With that, wow, you just finished the full production phase. It was so easy, right? Right?
Now we can move on to post-production phase, where you need to render all of your stuff and make the final edit with all the sound design and music. If you have a potato PC, you can use something like Render Farms to speed up the rendering phase. When it comes to compositing, you can use DaVinci Resolve or my personal favorite, Nuke, to spice up your renders. If you want to get started with Nuke, here are some good tutorials on the basics.
And with that, we can move on to... Oh wait! We did everything, by now you would have a finished film.
But if you're thinking, man, ain't no way this workflow will work. Well, random strawman, you won't believe this, but Pixar, for example, uses a very small blueprint to create their movies. And you know, I think they create pretty good shit. Most of the time.
Obviously, I modified this pipeline to fit more individuals or smaller teams.
But as you can see, the workflow works.
So go ahead and create your films.
But wait, if you want a deeper look into this pipeline and learn even more, watch my devlogs, where I document all of the progress I am making, like in this video where I am creating realistic characters from concept art to actual 3D models.